Hi, I'm here to talk to you today about teaching your dog how to do a stay, especially a sit stay. Once a dog has mastered a sit stay, we can move on to a down stay and a stand stay. But the sit stay is the one that we need to use the most. In order to teach a dog a sit stay, there's several pieces of equipment you need. One is a leash. I prefer leather leashes, but any kind of leash would be good. Eventually, as you get along in your training, you may want to use a retractable leash. I only use these under very certain circumstances, only when absolutely necessary, not most of the time for walking my dog. The dog must also have a collar on. I prefer a buckle collar for teaching in this manner. If I were to use a slip lead, a collar, I will attach the lead to the collar itself, not to either of the rings. The reason is I'm going to use a little bit of tension on the line to get a little pressure on the back of the dog. In addition to that, I need a lot of wonderful treats. They should be small, about the size of a raisin, soft and easy for the dog to eat and chew. As you can see, Treasure thinks they're pretty wonderful. If I have a small dog, I like to teach them the sit stay up on top of a platform. This is simply a pan that I bought at a feed store. They come in a variety of sizes. This is perfect for a small puppy, a toy breed, any dog that weighs probably less than 15 pounds. They have larger sizes that are appropriate for larger dogs. In addition to that, I'm going to need a variety of toys and other things, such as balls, to help proof the sit stay. To start out with my sit stay, Treasure already has her leash on her collar attached in the way that I showed you. I'm going to ask her to sit. Treasure, come over here and sit. I'm asking her to sit at my left side. Treasure knows that the word yes means she's done what I wanted her to do and also that she's probably going to get a reward. It's called a conditioned reinforcer. When I start teaching my young dog to stay, I start with the dog right next to me in a sit and my leash right out in front. I have a tiny bit of tension on it. The tension helps the dog by using a little bit of oppositional reflex. All dogs have that reflex. They pull against things that pull against them. So by using it, I can help her to understand the stay. I simply say stay, I use my hand in front, and I step in front of the dog. Notice that there's still a little bit of tension on the leash. I tell her, good stay, yes, good stay, and I give her a treat. Good stay. Excellent. I only hold for a few seconds and then I return. And now I must use a release word. The release word should be something that you only use for this purpose and not for any other purpose. In this case, for this dog, the word is hang loose. And as you can see, she gets right up from her sit stay. Come back here again and we'll show you. Demonstrate again. Sit and stay. She must stay. She must stay until I either return and give the release word or I give her another command. For instance, I may call her to my front or I may ask her to lie down, any other kind of thing I want her to do. But she must stay until I tell her either that or give her the release word. I always return to her side before I give her the release word early in training. Later on, I'll be doing some other things. Now, I'm going to add treats. As often as I feel the dog needs them, this dog has been trained to do a sit stay and can stay for a long time, so she doesn't need a lot of treats. If she was a puppy, I'd be giving her treats constantly. Good dog, yes. Good dog. Lots and lots of treats. Lots of treats. Over time, I put the interval between treats becomes longer and longer, and my sit stay becomes longer. I start always very close to my dog on leash so I can control. I don't go off leash until I have the dog thoroughly understanding the concept of stay. I want that dog to be able to hold a 1 minute stay with me at an end of the leash, a 6 foot leash, before I do anything else. Then I begin to proof the stay. Proofing means stay. This dog will stay even if I bounce the ball, throw it over her head, offer her a squeaky toy, toss a toy,
use a funny little toy.
What a stay, Treasure. She's doing very well. Because she's doing so well, I'm going to give her a treat. Even if a ball were to move by her, she would definitely stay. Treasure, stay. Good stay. I tell her, good job. Excellent. Well done. Treasure, hang loose. Hang loose.
Good job.
Excellent. We're going to try one more thing. Sit and stay. Now, I want to be sure that you always use the word stay only when you mean the dog must stay in that position. I don't use the word wait when I mean stay. The word wait is much more casual. I use that if I'm going to leave the room and I don't want the dog to come with me. Wait essentially means you're not coming with me, you wait here. Stay means you stay in this position until I either give you another command or I release you. So, right now, I can tell her to stay and I can leave the building. Treasure, stay. As you can see, she did stay. This is because her stay has been well proved. She gets her reward while she's in the stay, not when she's done. That encourages her to want to stay. So, when I release her, I never give her a treat then. I only give them to her while she's being a very good dog and is in her sit-stay. That's our lesson for today. Check back with some of our other videos, especially on how to use the platforms for very small dogs. In addition, you may refer to my article on sit-stays, which you can find on extension.org in the companion animal section. Thank you.